I've loved every minute of coming to Hampton. It's built unbelievable foundations for all of us to move on to the next chapters of our lives. The class of 2022 all get along very well, very friendly group of people and just fun to be around. Celebrating each other and the successes that we had was something that was very special about our year group. I'm really going to miss it, but what an amazing time we all had.
Floating around in ecstasy, so don't stop me now. Don't stop me now.
Having a good time, having a good time.
You shouldn't stop leaping through the sky.
As we celebrate our class of 2022, it's clear to see that a good time was had by all.
The year group bonded through shared experiences from first year to sixth form.
They came through the COVID-19 pandemic together and all that entailed, including the cancellation of their GCSEs.
It made the news on A-Level Results Day all the sweeter.
Results Day was fantastic. Everyone's there with their parents celebrating.
It was a really great atmosphere. Everyone was really proud and happy together, and that made it so joyful.
The 2022 A-level results were exceptional. A remarkable 89% of grades were A star or A, and 75 boys in the year achieved 3 or more A stars, with many, including Daniel Morgan and Pallav Bagchi, achieving 4 straight A-star grades.
I feel like it's both the teaching and the hard work that gave us the results that we have now. I got into Imperial to study aeronautical engineering on a presidential scholarship. I feel so blessed. Honestly, it's been a dream of mine since I was young.
Daniel chose to follow his passion and study music at Cambridge. His Hampton performances will long be remembered.
Well, my highlight for sure was playing the piano with the orchestra, playing Shostakovich's second piano concerto. It was just incredible to sit there at the front of the orchestra in front of a packed Hammond Theatre and play a piece which I just love so much. So much fun, so joyful, but with some beautiful melodies. I was just amazed by the reception it got at the end. There was a lot of clapping and it was a moment I'll never forget.
Linguists Patrick Helm and Niaz Hashim also celebrated superb A-level results, topping off an excellent year that saw them crown national French debating champions.
The motion was, should we listen to reason over passion? And we had to defend passion and say that, no, we should trust our emotions. At the start of the debate, we were maybe on the losing side, but then my friend and colleague, Nehaz, was able to kind of use one of their points against them to say that, you know, you're using passion to defend reason, and that kind of flipped the balance.
And for them to be able to debate with so much class, so much composer is quite astonishing, really.
When they called our name at the end, it felt fantastic.
I think you can see my reaction in the video. I was very surprised.
I think my reaction was pretty much like that of Patrick. I just went, come on, boys, they so deserved it. We were all so happy and proud of the boys.
Throughout their time at Hampton, the class of 2022 has excelled across the performing arts.
The many memorable music and drama performances have allowed their vast range of creative talents to shine.
The sheer joie de vivre of our musicians and dramatists was clear to see in the showcase production of the year, the Senior School Musical.
Doing Guys and Dolls last year, I think, was such a fantastic experience. It was so much fun.
So I was the lead in Guys and Dolls. I was Sky Masterson, who's this high roller gambler who comes to the city.
Yeah, I was Nicely Johnson. I was sort of the comedic character, let's say.
We have Mrs. Tate from LEH as our dance coordinator. We were doing a Havana dance.
10 minutes in, she was like, oh, you have to lift someone. I was like, oh, I can do that.
Apparently it's a thing every year where the girls are far better at the dancing than we
they
are.
They were, to be
they,
fair.
They were.
But it was like boot camp for us.
It really was. We were all aching and whinging after every dance session.
Seriously.
Hard work, but so rewarding.
Yeah. The rush you get, the high, when everyone's like clapping after you finish a song.
Best feeling I think I've ever had.
So unbelievable, yeah.
Another highlight was the Voices of Lyons trip to the Edinburgh Fringe.
Like, I would never have imagined before I came to Hampton being a part of an all-male a cappella choir.
To wake the nations underground.
Going to Edinburgh each year is just one of the best trips you can do at Hampton.
I remember actually going to see them when I was in first year. I was just in absolute awe of them, thinking, when my voice drops, fingers crossed if it ever does, I honestly couldn't wait to join.
Edinburgh was probably the culmination of our, like, it was the pinnacle of our Voices of Lyons career, wasn't it? It was unbelievable, just kind of all the buzz around the city.
So the solo Edinburgh Fringe, I did Bridge Over Troubled Water. I think the church that we did it in, completely different to here, like the atmosphere kind of just upped it a little bit and everyone just sang so much better. The acoustics in there were just phenomenal. When you sing like a good solo with some really good singers behind you singing some a cappella, it's really nice.
It's literally nothing but us and our voices. It can create such an amazing sound and such a variety of sounds without an instrument, just with our voices. I think that's really cool.
It's said that you never know anyone as well as your school friends, and where better to share reflections on fellow classmates than in the Hampton School Diary Room.
Who's most likely to return to Hampton as a teacher?
Oh.
I mean, you would think like someone smart, surely.
I think Jay Sarhar is
Jay
a teacher.
Sarhar.
Give him 4 years and he's coming back.
Ooh.
Mr. Beck.
What? I forgot the question, sir.
Jay Sarhar.
Come back as a geography teacher.
I'm going to say Jay Sarhar. Oh,
I think he could fit in well, you know.
Sir, can I have some sandwiches, please?
I feel like Ben Francis.
Ben Francis. Gives off very English teacher vibes.
Yeah, I could see Ben as a teacher. Because he's very knowledgeable.
Who's the wisest Hamptonian? Oh. Wisest? So that implies like old.
Yeah, Palabagshi.
He seems to have always giving me homework.
Yeah.
Finlow. Finlow without a shadow of a doubt.
I think Finlow gives off wise words.
Even if not what he's saying is wise.
Yeah. I'd like to call myself wise.
I think it's me, actually.
That's probably me, to be honest.
But then we can agree it's not him.
Who is most likely to become a spy or work for MI6?
Who's the most mysterious?
Who's something you don't know anything about?
I was thinking, out of many secrets.
I've been friends for 5 years. I know his first name is Sam.
Sam Colwyn.
Oh, yeah.
Sam Colwyn
is Russian.
But surely it's got to be Sam Colwyn. He literally does history, politics, and Russian.
I'm a double agent.
Mayars, maybe.
You know who? It'll be Mayars.
Surely he's getting a call from him.
Might get a little bit of a tap on the shoulder.
He's just kind of mysterious.
He definitely see you, Mayars.
Ethan Cox.
I can see
Yeah, I think he's got he's like the James Bond kind of spy. He's got the suaveness.
I reckon Ethan Cox would make a good spy.
Yes.
It's like some second dad.
Yeah, no,
Black.
Sport plays an integral role in the lives of so many Hamptonians.
The class of 2022 have many fond and proud memories to look back upon.
Overall, we had a brilliant season and put in strong performances at School's Head and the Bedford and Star Regattas. We crossed the line in first place at the British Rowing Championships and received an array of medals at the Home International Regatta. We had a great win at Henley Royal Regatta. It's kind of what every schoolboy rower dreams of being able to do, to race down that Henley stretch.
Looking pretty tidy. Hampton crew still in the lead here.
Cox and that crew were such a privilege. They're friends for life. There was great camaraderie in the team.
As they come across the line there, it is the Hampton School in the Princess Elizabeth Challenge Cup.
Winning that race at Henley was a great way to finish off our time at Hampton.
The highlight of our season was undeniably Wrexham, when we beat them 3-2 on the 3G in the quarterfinals of ISFA. In typical Hampton fashion, we looked like we were beaten.
As the game entered its closing phase, we were 2-0 down. But in time-honoured fashion, Hampton dug deep.
So the first goal was Nat, probably with about 20 minutes to go. It was a typical scrappy goal, but in those situations, they're the goals that count most. The second goal was Sam Evans, school captain. From left back, he scored a proper screamer. It was with seconds to go. It's gone far post, and everyone went crazy on the sideline. All the lads have jumped into the crowd. It was a very, very special, surreal moment.
The winning goal came in extra time, courtesy again of Nat Willihan, assisted by Ben Bird.
I take a look to my right and I see Nat sprinting in. I play it across the floor and Nat somehow managed to finish it, and yeah, it was pandemonium.
You couldn't quite believe that you'd actually come back from 2-0 down, and the circumstance we'd done it was great.
That drive and determination was also evident in the year group's B squad footballers, who, starting its under-14s, made Hampton history.
So the B team I was in, I'm in third, fourth and fifth year, reached the final of the ESWA Cup 3 years a row, which was amazing.
Good work from back. Good game, this.
Massive venues. We had loads of fans for our year there. Some really funny chants. It was just a real occasion.
The summer term saw our cricketers come to the fore.
There was a lot of strong performances this year from the team. We really gelled together.
One of the biggest standout performances this year was Alex Zotov against St George's Weybridge in a T20 match. He bowled an outstanding spell, took 5 wickets for a very small amount of runs.
Arjun Bhatt took 6 wickets against Dulwich College. He's been wanting to get on the honours board for the last 2 years, so it's finally good that he's got on there. But no, really outstanding performances from the upper six.
Standout performances in the St Joseph's Festival augured well for Hampton Rugby. The first 15 duly went on to reach the final stages of the prestigious RFU Schools Cup. Notable victories included a close win against Dulwich.
Losing, we didn't think was really an option, especially with Mr Beattie as the head coach, being a Hampton boy himself.
Fighting the wind and rain, the game remained at 7 apiece when captain Ethan Knight saw his opportunity.
We got a scrum on their 22. Ethan wanted me to grab a kick in just behind them for him to pick it up, and it sort of just popped up for him in time, didn't it? And Ethan just dived on it.
He just sprung up and immediately straight beelined it to Arthur's dad for the celebrations. It was just such a good moment.
You know, it epitomises what Hampton Rugby was all about, really. Also sport in general, I think, why it's so good to play at Hampton, because that feeling with your mates after a game like that,
yeah, exactly.
The togetherness,
the changing room as well.
It's just, yeah, nothing beats it really, I think.
Every year group has its iconic moments that become embedded in Hampton folklore.
What Hampton moment will you never forget?
The email, for sure.
It's got to be Rizwan's email.
It's got to be, yeah. Rizwan, Hatimi, sent an email to the entire school, that's it.
As a fresh-faced new third year, Rizwan Hatimi was anxious not to miss out on a careers talk with a visiting medical professor.
So whilst everyone was on their bus on the way home, I sent the following email. Dear Miss Tennyson,
Thank you for bringing this wonderful opportunity to my home at Hampton School. I truly do appreciate it. I am Rizwan Hatimi in Form 3D, Mr. Baker, and I am incredibly interested in medicine and biological studies. It is actually my favourite subject. I am extremely looking forward to a medicine career, and I would like to snap at this opportunity, Miss Tennyson, to have a small chat with this spectacular man. God knows what was wrong with me in that split second. I clicked reply all, typed the nerdiest email of my life, and sent it off to the entire school. Not soon after, I realised that Hampton was actually like really, really fun place. Everyone took it as a joke, and I got so, so many replies. Someone copied and pasted the whole Genesis and Exodus into the school email.
Exodus, just rolling through on the email.
Exodus, the B-movie, US Constitution.
I got the most Hampton reply ever, and someone put the numerical value of pi.
All of the digits of pi to like,
yeah, exactly.
100,000.
A million decimal places.
Yeah.
I got a reply of a recipe for a gingerbread man.
Like, he was a celebrity.
Yeah, people were signing their, he was signing people's
homework. I know, like.
I went onto the 3G with a couple of people, and this other six, I don't know his name, but he was really tall, and he just picked me up behind me. I didn't even realize it was coming. He ran up behind me, picked me up, put him on his shoulders and said, "The Risington Revolution has begun." And everyone was there just cheering. The autographs, the main thing I can say is that there were just hundreds of them. I actually think that whilst it was a mistake, it actually turned out to help me really settle in. It set the tone of a really fun Hampton experience, and I knew that I was going to enjoy Hampton from then on.
Who had the most shocking haircut?
Ooh. There's been quite a few.
Will. It's gotta be Will.
It's gotta be
Will. It's gotta be Will Lingfist. Like,
yeah, the, I don't know,
the buzz cut.
The buzz cut, mate. What was that about?
A lot of my mates were getting buzz cuts, so I was like, to my mum, can you give me one? Because I thought it was quite easy to do. You just sort of shave the head. Like, what can go wrong with that?
And I was quite surprised when I had finished because he looked better than I thought he would. At that point, I needed to oil the blades. So I just said to William, please, can I just run it through your hair again to sort of spread it out a bit? And completely forgot to put the little extra plastic thing on to give the space between the head and the hair. So I ended, I ended up cutting a road in the middle of the head.
In a buzz cut, a bowl patch going all the way down my head, like a racing strip. So it was not a good trim.
Yeah. His mum still cuts his hair, I think.
Yeah, my mum's the best, despite her varying performances, but obviously I do love her, so it's fine.
He took that really well. But it took some time before we got the trimmers out again.
The lockdown brought quite a few haircuts out, yeah. Quite a few new styles.
Or to be fair, some mullets as well. Actually, this is a good one. Ben Wharton's mullet.
Ben Wharton's mullet was particularly interesting last year.
Jude's mullet now is pretty strong.
For me, at least, Eddie Bruce, I think.
Noah Wood.
Yeah, definitely. It was a lack of haircut, so like it just looked like a mop on my head.
Javi Mercer.
Shocking haircut.
Javi Mercer.
Javi, definitely.
You know, D of E, he had the R9 haircut fully done.
Yeah, no, we've had a lot of shockers over our time at Hampton.
I think what makes Hampton such a great school is that you can actually be who you are and you will be cherished.
Allowing everyone to be true to themselves has always been a keystone of a Hampton education.
It offers a really caring environment here and they'll support you in all things you want to do.
Thank you for, in a school of so many pupils, making me feel like I actually matter.
As we bid a fond farewell to our class of 2022, we wish them all the best as they move on to the next stages of their lives. Thank you for all your contributions across all of school life. And remember, once a Hamptonian, always a Hamptonian.
I'd say thank you and good luck to all my mates going forward. It's going to be fun.
I'd just like to say a massive thank you to Hampton for all the opportunities it's given me.
I mean, there's not been a single day where I didn't wake up excited to come to school.
Oh, it's been such a laugh. So I look back on it now and it feels like yesterday it was first year.
I've had so much fun at Hampton. It's been such a pleasure.
Awesome. Yeah. So much fun.
You know, I'm definitely proud to say I'm a Hamptonian.
100% going to miss this place and everybody in it.
I've met some very lovely people.
It's just great to see everyone has made the most of their time at Hampton and it's brilliant to look back on and to be proud of.
things that are truly priceless about a Hampton education are both the friends that you make when you're here and the memories that you have when you leave.
The saying, like, once a Hamptonian, always a Hamptonian, you really do feel a part of the community.
So many great memories, met so many great people, and I think Hampton's going to stay with me for the rest of my life.